Hi everyone, in this video we are going to see about Nifty breakout levels and we will give some update about market also. By watching this video you can gain more knowledge about market so that you can start your trade on your own for the coming week. So we will give you and we will update you about the intraday levels also, and we will tell you what happened on the Friday market also, so that you can have some idea what is going on the previous week, and you can also have some sight what to do for the coming week also. Okay, those who are new to channel, kindly subscribe the channel and select the ring bell for continuous updates of my videos. If you feel like the video, kindly select the like button and share it. By selecting the name of this channel, NSC Commodity Trader, you will go to homepage. In homepage, you can see more strategy and indicator videos. By watching this video, you can gain more knowledge about market. We are also taking more advanced trading strategy class, and we are also providing levels for commodity also, like crude, copper, zinc and gold. If you want to know about these details means, you can WhatsApp or contact the number which is given below the video. Let's come back to Nifty. Nifty ended up as a another bearish week, but before Friday it was just a range in market, like that we can say, because on Monday it's a big candle, big downside happened, but after that market was stuck in a range between 11,100 to 11,400. This is the range that market got stuck in the previous week, but today on Friday the market opened as a huge gap down, like almost around like a 400 point gap down. After that point gap down, market even pulled down, and during the downside it went down up to 11,827 range. After it touches the 11,800, market made some recovery, and after some news came in the mid of the market, market started to rally to the upside, and when it tried to break out this 11,000 range, it didn't do the successful of 11,000 breakout, so market closed below 11,000. So market ended up near to 11,000, so it is like a negativeness to the market. Okay, let's take a look what happened to the market, why market down like that. Okay, everyone knows that the market mainly down because of the virus, that is coronavirus case that is going on everywhere all around the world. More than 60 countries have been infected by the coronavirus. There is only one positive thing for India, that the virus cannot able to spread in India because of the high temperature. Okay, but many of them are get infected due to going to out other countries and getting infected from the other country peoples, like that it's spoiling. But this week mostly down has been happened because of the reason of the spike of 30 cases has been spiked in India, including 14 Italian members, and so we ended up as we have 30 coronavirus cases. And then one more thing, we are getting affected by the global market also, because global market also started to pull down our Nifty on Thursday, likely around 4% down from the US market. Due to that 4% down, that affected our Indian market also. Due to that only, on Friday it opened as a gap down. After that gap down also, there is one more news that affected our market. That is none other than Yes Bank news, because Yes Bank has fallen most on the record. Because of the fall of Yes Bank, what is the fall like that if you ask means? RBI has taken over the Yes Bank. At first, before Friday, the news came like SBI going to buy some stake of the Yes Bank. So it looked like a positive news for the Yes Bank, like that happened. So that day Yes Bank even rallied to the upside. But after the end of the market, they said they are going to buy the Yes Bank at the price of 2 rupees because of the face value. So market is going to fall, that is what predicted by the everyone, and market continuously done the lower fees because of the people's mood off, like how to say, 50,000 limit, and then many all the net banking had got shut down for the Yes Bank, like that so many things has been happened for the Yes Bank. It ended up as a fearfulness for all the private banks, because it is like a affecting all the private bank, even IndusInd Bank, RBI Bank also started to falling because of their negative news happening for those banks. So if RBI is going to take over means, that means it's going to be close as shut down, like that is going to happen. People started to fear, like that the news started to roll out, rumor started to roll out. But Around 12 p.m., RBI governor assured that S Bank account holders will not worry about it because we will support you, like that they said. And for 30 days, even they given limit, and every day you can withdraw up to 50,000. And they have even given exception case for marriages, medicals, like that they give even exception case, they can withdraw more money also. So after this news came, RBI governor has assured for it. So after that, market started to recover. Until this news came, even S Bank also not even recovered. It ended up as trading at rupees 5.60. It is more like a penny stock, like that the range it came. But after the RBI governor assurance, market started to rally to the upside. During that rally only, even S Bank closed above 15 point, and then Nifty also recovered near, came near to 11,000. After market closed, Sitaraman announcement has given to the press release. During that press release, we will not let any institution fall. As I have repeatedly said, I will not allow any institution to fall off a cliff, like that she said. So she is assuring that all the banks do not worry about it, and we will be back up with the S Bank, like that RBI and Finance Minister has said. So due to this news came, the market, we can expect some positiveness in the market, but the market is getting fear from the coronavirus. So you need to look out for the sell side market only. Whatever the fundamental news came, if a single coronavirus report came in, it is going to affect the market. Okay, when can we expect the market to rebound? When can we expect the market to bounce back? Like that if you ask, means market will only bounce back after the medicine has been founded for coronavirus. Until that news came, market is going to be on the selling side only. It is going to fall until the news came out from the pharma sector. Currently, the sector that has been on continuous upside, there are two sectors, Nifty IT sector, Nifty Pharma sector. Those were the sectors that ended up as a positiveness. In Nifty Pharma also, like DV's Lab, Dr. Reddy, they are the one positiveness from this virus market. In this virus market, only pharma sectors are on currently positiveness. Let's take a look at the weekly candle. In weekly candle, it's clearly shown as a big bearish candle. Bearish candle that started before the week. After that, a long bearish candle, and then again a bearish candle that has been formed. During this week, 11,800 has been touched, and on the upside, the 11,400 is forming as a major resistance. Let's come back to the daily chart. So we can see what are all the support and resistance we can expect for the coming market, for coming week. Okay, for the coming week, the market should need to go above 11,000. If market didn't hold this 11,000 range, means we cannot expect positiveness from the market. So market should need to hold out this 11,000 range. And once the market open, you need to watch out where it is moving like that. So kindly wait for 5 minutes and just observe the market. Either it is going after maximum gap up or gap down only will happen. Gap up will happen only if the virus case will get reduced. Gap down will happen if virus case got increased. Okay, so we cannot go and count what happened to the coronavirus case, but we can just simply watch gap up or gap down. And if a gap down happened, means it is a negative market. So wait until 5 minutes, see if it's falling after opening also, means you can just sell it. But if it didn't falling, it is making a recover, means you can also buy it, and you can expect the market to be on the positive side. Okay, if it is a gap up, then it is going to be a buying market only. Within 2 minutes you can judge that the market is going on, market is going rally to the upside or downside. Okay, 3/4, if market opened above 11,000, it is going to be a positive market only. Okay, and for coming week, 11,400 is going to be the major resistance, and the major support is going to be 11,800. So these are the major support and resistance. If you see any breakout in these sections, means you can expect market to be more positive side if it break above 11,400. Meanwhile, if it break 10,800, it is going to be the more negative side for the market also. Okay, we are also taking more advanced trading strategy class, and we are also providing levels for commodity like crude, copper, zinc and gold. If you want to know about these details, means you can WhatsApp or contact the number. In future, if you want to see more videos like this, means kindly subscribe my channel and select the ring bell. If you want to open a DMAT or trading account, kindly select the link in below description or contact the number. Guidance will be provided for you. Thank you.